All right, so you wanted to really dig into this new album from Daniil Trifonov, My American Story North. And just say up front, not your usual classical record.
No, not even close. I mean, this is the pianist that the New York Times called incandescent.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and Gramophone. They said, the most astounding young pianist of our age. Like, those are some serious accolades.
You're not messing around with those descriptions.
No.
When you hear demonic and tenderness used all to describe how one person plays the piano, you know there's something special happening.
Oh, for sure. And you know, the crazy thing is, like, his technical skill, it's almost a given at this level.
Right, like, he can clearly play the piano.
It's how he plays, you know. The personality, the experiences, he packs it all into the music. And that's where this album gets, I think, really, really interesting.
Yeah, because My American Story, it doesn't just stay in the classical lane.
Nope.
You've got Gershwin, okay, but then Art Tatum, which is jazz piano legend.
Oh, yeah.
We've got film scores in there.
Wow.
There's even like a minimalist piece inspired by Beethoven. It's all over the place in a good way.
And that's what makes it so Trifonov, right? Huh. Because you think about his background, coming to the U.S. from Russia at 17 to study music.
Yeah.
He didn't just come here and like hole up in a practice room.
Right.
This guy, he dove headfirst into American culture, absorbing everything.
That totally comes through.
Yeah.
And he seems to have really fallen hard for Art Tatum, especially while he was at the Cleveland Institute of Music. He even transcribed I Cover the Waterfront for this album.
Oh, wow.
That's some dedication. This wasn't just a casual, oh, I like that song.
No, and it's like this direct line you can almost draw, right?
Ah.
Because there's this great story about Vladimir Horowitz, and I mean, Horowitz, another pianist who needs no introduction, but he once said that he would quit playing if Art Tatum ever got serious about classical music.
Really?
Yeah, like that's how good Tatum was.
Wow. High praise. So we've got Trifonov, incredible talent, soaking up all this American music and then pouring it back out into his own playing. I can't wait to see how it all comes together. So it's not just him like geeking out over American music, right? There's a real structure to this album.
Oh, totally. It's like bookended, right? You've got these two piano concertos, almost like pillars.
Okay.
Gershwin's concerto in F at the beginning, and then at the very end, a brand new concerto.
Yeah.
Written for Trifonov by Mason Bates.
Oh, wow. And this is the world premiere recording of that Bates piece.
World premiere recording.
Wow. That's pretty incredible.
It really is, yeah. Like being handed the keys to, you know, a brand new car and you get to take it for its first spin.
Yeah.
And the way Trifonov was talking about the Gershwin, he actually described it as like a chase scene in a black and white movie through Chicago.
I love that. You can just picture it, like, immediately.
Yeah.
But okay, so you got these two big concertos, but it's the stuff in between that I'm really curious about. Like, there's Copland on here, but he didn't go for, like, the big, you know, Americana sound.
Right.
He chose the piano variations, which I read is, like, one of the most technically demanding pieces on the entire album.
And that just shows you, again, right, like, this is a musician who is not afraid to challenge himself, challenge the listener. He really wants to dig into all these different corners of what American music can be.
It's a Gacy saying, there's more to the story here than you might think.
Yeah.
And for our listener who might not be familiar with all these composers, you know, how would you describe the approach he's taking here?
It's almost like he's choosing pieces that are very connected to specific places or even experiences. So it's not just, you know, playing the notes of the page. He's telling you a story.
And it gets really personal.
Oh, yeah.
He includes Bill Evans's version of When I Fall in Love, which is like a classic jazz standard.
Absolutely.
But you get the sense that it's one he connects with, like on a really emotional level.
Deeply personal.
I actually read that he considers this whole album to be his love letter to his adopted home. Makes you wonder, like, Before he lived here, before all this, what was his image of America?
You know, it's funny you should mention that, because he's talked about how, even before moving to the U.S., Hollywood really shaped his view.
Hmm.
And then you look at the track list, and there's music from American Beauty, from The Firm. Like, it all kind of clicks.
It's like we're hearing the soundtrack to his first impressions.
Exactly.
And then, just when you think you've got a handle on things, there's the John Cage piece. Now, just so everyone's on the same page, 4433, it's famous for being, well, silence.
Oh yeah, super famous and often misunderstood.
Mm.
It's not about no sound, right? Mm. It's about the sounds we don't think about as music. And Trifonov takes that and he records his version outdoors in New York.
Uh-huh.
Calls it Cage at Columbus.
So instead of a silent concert hall, we're getting the city itself.
Yeah.
The traffic, people talking, all of that.
That becomes the music.
Yeah.
And honestly, I think that's like the perfect sonic metaphor, you know?
Oh yeah.
For Trifonov, coming here, his American story, it's about that energy.
Yeah.
The mix of everything, the soundscape of a city like New York. It might not always be pretty, might not always be, you know, in tune, but it's alive.
He's embracing all of it. It's like he's saying, this is my America. Mm. Not just the postcard version, but the whole thing.
Yeah, warts and all.
It really makes you think about how, where we come from, what we've lived through, it shapes how we hear everything.
Oh, absolutely.
And speaking of stories continuing, his wife is from the Dominican Republic, and they're working on a whole other album all about Latin American music.
My American Story South.
Yeah.
Like, I am so there for that. It just shows you this journey, this musical exploration, it never really ends.
It really doesn't. And for anyone listening, I want to leave you with this. One of the articles we read, it said that if Trifonov hadn't become a pianist, he probably would have been an urban planner.
Wow.
Makes you think, right?
It really does. Like, when you hear this album, how much of it is him shaping sound the way someone designs a city?
Designing whole soundscapes. We're going to have to revisit this when South comes out.
100%.
But for now, everyone listening, go check out My American Story North. Let us know what you hear in it. And until next time, happy listening.
Contemporary Classical Music Podcast explores the ever-evolving landscape of classical and contemporary music. From reviews of new compositions to deep dives into the works of iconic composers, this podcast blends education and appreciation for music across different eras. Whether you're passionate about traditional symphonies or intrigued by cutting-edge soundscapes, join us as we discover the art of music in all its forms.